got to get back before Cleveland realizes I'm not in bed.
Donna! Donna!
If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits? Putting on the Ritz.
Welcome back to Top 10 Unintentionally Funny Meg's Archive Statements. Coming in at number 6, we have number 34, Anatomy Class. First of all, I'm convinced that nothing supernatural happened in this episode. That's just what medical students are like. Second of all, everyone is sleeping on the most iconic line in the whole show. How sharp should knees be? Coming in at number 5, we have 97, We All Ignore the Pit. Or should I say, we all ignore this episode. Everyone just walked into a hole. And that was the whole episode.
That's not scary, that's great. I want to walk into a hole with my friends and family.
Which brings me to number whatever number I'm on. Number 152, A Gravedigger's Envy. My man just needed a nap, and he decided to take that nap in an empty grave, and I don't think there's anything wrong with that. And I think it's number 4, but I'm not... I don't even need to explain this one. Like for part 3.
Justin, the all-seeing, all-knowing eye!
Into a fictional character, go.
Jonah Magnus from the Magnus Archive.
Got it? Okay, we're going to put that to the side for a second. We'll come back to it in a moment. And now I want you to think of a typical New Year's resolution.
Losing weight. No. Love life.
Got it?
Love life.
No, I want you to change it to something so opposite from that first one you thought of. Something completely, completely different. Go.
Killing and sacrificing your lovers.
Got it? Okay, so this character has to complete this New Year's resolution by the end of the year. How will
they
do it?
He's already done it.
Are you talking about Marie Antoinette?
Yeah.
I heard a thing or two about her.
And I'm eating my computer. Crunch, crunch, crunch. Keyboard keys for breakfast, dinner, and lunch. You see the red chip from my lips. I call this snack computer chips. Whoa, and I chew it up, it's on the screen, but it...
Quite divine tonight, here among these vibrant lights. Pure delight surround us as we sail. Sign yours truly, the whale.
Alice in Wonderland entrance in Deep Cave, Cardiff Valley, Texas.
Nice. Statement of Laura Popham regarding her experience exploring the Three Counties system of caves with her sister Elena Sanderson. Original statement given November the 9th, 2014. Audio recording by Jonathan Sims, head archivist of the Magnus Institute, London. Statement begins.
It's hard to believe I'm walking through the ruins of the first ever city, because I'm not. That's in Iraq, which is miles away.
You can't handle the uber instincts of my uber autism. Observe.
Jürgen Leitner, stupid idiot motherfucking Jürgen Leitner, goddamn fool, book collecting, dust eating, rat old bastard, shithead idiot avatar of the whore, biggest clown in the circus, laughed out of town cowboy motherfucking Jürgen Leitner.
Don't you understand, oh my little girl, all I ever wanted, all I ever needed is here, it's my arms.
Control guy.
came by yesterday. He marched inside too eagerly, so I stopped him. Look, I like the wasps. They don't hurt anyone, so don't mess with them. He spoke with an arrogance that disgusted me, and did what the god sent him to do. You see, for a year they lived with me, and every evening I'd walk to their window, press my head against the glass, and share all my drunken rambles with them. They never minded. They just stayed put, pressing their heads against the glass as well. I went back to the window just now, and I saw one of them lying dead on the sash. I leaned my head against the glass, rinsed my mouth with some wine, and cried to him for a bit. And he stayed put, just like he always had before. But now a trail of ants march up the window to do what the gods sent them to do.
Dang it, Jim, I'm an astronomer, not a doctor. I mean, I am a doctor, but I'm not that kind of doctor. I have a doctorate. It's not the same thing. You can't help people with a doctorate. You just sit there and you're useless.
Hello, John. Apologies for the deception, but I rather wanted to make sure you started reading, so I thought it best not to announce myself.
You can't handle the Uber instincts of my Uber autism. Observe.
Jürgen Leitner, stupid idiot motherfucking Jürgen Leitner, goddamn fool, book collecting, dust eating, rat old bastard, shithead idiot avatar of the whore, biggest clown in the circus, laughed out of town, cowboy motherfucking Jürgen Leitner.
Do you really think you can stop me?
Oh, maybe not. But you're forgetting we're in a room full of magical artifacts, and I don't know what any of them do!
Filled almost to bursting, the bag tore open easily. From the newly ripped hole, poured teeth.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! It's Spider-Man! It's Spider-Man! Spider-Man! He's coming to four-
of my sweetheart's face, it fires the heart and sets the pace. Whate'er the time, where'er the place, I'll find him through the depths of space. Singing, pump me, boys, let her fly down to hell and up to the sky. Bend your backs and break your bones.
Autistic characters should be played by autistic actors only, otherwise it's ableist casting.
Oh, you really believe that, don't you?
I do, I've said it on multiple occasions. Okay, so I'll just do us a favor and take this one away then.
No, no, not that one.
Well, that's a problem. But not my fault. I did everything I could, and you did too. Also, why are you still here?
Finger, one time, singing my life with his words.
crack of dawn. I embrace a new man every night. My life's one never-ending carnival. A whirl of boozy, floozy, flashing light. I want to be that fucked up girl. I want to be that fucked up
My vision for Magnus Post-Canon? Oh, I thought you'd never ask. Well, first off, it is, of course, a sitcom, and it opens with Martin, John, Jonah, and Annabelle all waking up in the basement of Alternate 105 Hilltop Road. Annabelle is there because she said she'd also likely get pulled through, and Jonah because his body also wasn't found in the wreckage of the Panopticon. Because squatting laws turn out to be different in Alternate England, the house is theirs now. So what you've got are the two finalists for the Mixed Cryptic UK competition, a magic evil bastard from the Victorian era who now has to get used to being a mundane evil bastard, and what is essentially a regular guy all sharing a house in Oxford. Plot lines include a neighbor knowing that somewhere in the four of them there's an essentially married couple but getting the wrong end of the heteronormative stick and thinking it's Martin and Annabelle, Jonah realizing that since he now has no more access to the Lucas family funds, he has to get a soul-crushing fast food job if you've seen Being Human, think Hal in season 4, but worse, and Martin finally taking his A-levels. Thank you.
This is my house. Entry, please. He is my neighbor, Nursultan Tuliakbai. He's pain in my assholes. I get a window from a glass, he must get a window from a glass. I get a step, he must get a step. I get a clock radio, he cannot afford. Great success.
Reaction.
Ooh. Okay, it's got a little kick. Oh.
One of my favorite things about season one Jonathan Sims is that he knew Tim was going on dates in order to extort like police information. He knew that Sasha was like breaking into secure databases in order to get info for the cases. And he was just like, I don't care if you're sleeping with police officers. I don't care if you're literally breaking probably like dozens of laws. I do not see, which is so silly and valid. And also ironically, so I avatar of him. I love Jonathan Sims. Nothing new is being said. Jonathan Sims. John. Sims.
Living gently in the cold dark.
Run, boy, run. They're trying to catch you.
And the worms crawl in, the worms crawl out.
I'm distracted, sons and daughters, out for slaughter. Turn the lights off.
Burn it all down, burn it all down, burn it all down.
I can't decide whether you should live or die.
Shouldn't we have something to eat?
say to you. Statement ends. This is written in French. All of it. I don't speak French. I don't read. I've never. I wish I could find it in myself to be surprised.
I just really like her and I don't know what to say to her.
Just go up to her, man. Just go up to her.
What? Just say anything?
Say anything.
Okay. Your ass makes me forget about my dead parents.
Three of us sleep next to three others. It's hot and we run this oven.
You can vouch for the soundness of my mind, can't you?
That is beside the point.
Funny story, really. I ran into the office. Worms everywhere, horrible death and everything.
I lit my lantern and... Martin. Good lord, man. If you're going to be staying in the archives, at least have the decency to put some trousers on.
So, do we know if it's pronounced Calliope or Calliope?
I have also heard it said as Calliope.
Seriously? By who?
Americans.
Ah.
Statement of Joe Spooky regarding sinister happenings.
Great! I should have known this was a complete waste of my time.
Probably.
Samantha Emery, she's lovely. She's actually doing a PhD in manifestations.
I don't care. LOL.
Martin keeps showing me his tongue and asking if it looks infested.
And the apple? Did you eat it?
Do I look like an idiot? Of course not! I brought you the two halves to see for yourselves.
Oh, good lord, that's...
Deeply unpleasant, yes. You can keep it if you want, as a proof.
We do not want it. And record... Oh, god damn it! Martin! Martin, where did you put the rest of the extinguishers? Martin! CO2, get the goddamn
right,
CO2!
Right.
Now!
Hey, yep.
Look, I know it's stupid.
Yes. Yes, it is. We don't have any sort of weapon, do we?
I mean, I suppose we could...
Don't say the corkscrew. Well, Martin, I guess this is...
Hi, guys.
You're not... You didn't die here, did you?
What? What? No, what?
No, I just... No, just the way you phrased that.
Did you think I was a ghost?
No.
Well, I've been using it to record myself. I write poetry, and I think the tapes have a sort of lo-fi charm.
I see.
Oh, they're coming over here. Please pretend I said something very humorous.
Got it. You're right, the Death Star does look like a huge deer.
Can I hear a little commotion for the dress? Hmm? A little bit? Now let's hear it for the back of the dress.
Gaslight. Gatekeep. Girl boss. Mansplain. Manipulate. Male wife.
This is the heaviest song you will ever fucking hear! The heaviest song we have ever written!
Met a girl and I really thought she liked me. Julie thought that I had met the one.
I do hope you're not planning to light those candles.
Oh goodness, a source of ignition in the archives. Uh-oh.
Tim.
Oh, whoops. Sorry, my hand slipped. And again, and again, and a couple more times here. I'm so clumsy today. That is a lot of
I'm
fire.
I'm really not comfortable.
So,
with...
blow them out then.
Oh. Right, yes.
And make a wish.
If I wish for you all to go away, do you think it'll work?
He's so grumpy today, isn't he, Martin?
Well...
Do you think it's his looming sense of mortality?
I don't...
Fine.
Whee!
So, what did you wish for?
can't tell you.
He wished for a little bit of peace and quiet.
Was it that obvious?
Oh, I wouldn't worry, John. It's an archive. Quiet is very much the course du jour.
How much can you see? What else do you know? Maybe everything.
What do you mean, everything?
I don't... Ask me a question. One I can't possibly know already.
Okay. What's my middle name?
You don't have one.
Whoa.
You... I actually believed you.
Sorry, I just wanted
to try
it out.
That's ridiculous, I thought. That's not a real name, but he wouldn't lie to me.
Okay. Let's try something a little bigger, then.
All right.
Stacey Tonner is a cop and a bastard, but she could threaten me with a knife, and I would thank her. She would be a D&D barbarian who refuses to rage. There are two kinds of comments on her page. One, all cops are bastards. Two, I am gay. That is what most of the Daisy comments say.
I'm genuinely gutted. We never got to do one that was fully based in a submarine. I really wanted to do a submarine one.
You were so pumped for a submarine episode.
I really, really wanted a submarine episode. I'm gutted we didn't get to do one of those.
It doesn't matter if you cause a little accident. We prefer to word it as mortal middle management. There's the door, we've got millions of applicants dying for some corporate incorporeal entanglement.
Nice onesie. Is it common men's?
Oh, I think you common men enough for all of us.
Oh, what's the name of that helper of yours?
Martin.
No, the hot one. He has scars like you, but kind of manages to pull them off.
Yes, Tim.
Yeah, what's his deal? He gave me the weirdest grin when I came in just now, and like, a thumbs up.
I wouldn't worry about it.
No?
He thinks we're sort of together.
Oh, no. You know I'm
no,
not...
No, I know. I mean, either he just got it in his head.
I mean, you're nice and all.
Yes, I feel the same way.
Right. I mean, I suppose it's better he think that.
I won't tell if you won't.
Right. I'm... gonna go, then.
Yes. I may not entirely trust my assistants, but I won't lose them.
I see you. Show yourself.
But I can hurt you. I see you, John.